He lay face down on the desert sand, clutching a six gun in his hand. Shot from behind, I thought he was dead, where under his heart was an ounce of lead. But a spark still burned, so I used my knife, and late that night, I saved the life of Ringo.
Ringo, Ringo.
I nursed him till the danger passed. The days went by, he mended fast. And then from dawn till setting sun, he practiced with that deadly gun. And hour on hour, I watched in awe. No human being could match the draw of Ringo. One day we rode the mountain crest, and I went east and he went west. I took to law and wore a star, while he spread terror near and far. With lead and blood he gained such fame, all through the west they feared the name of Ringo.
Ringo, Ringo.
I knew someday I'd face the test, which one of us would be the best. And sure enough, the word came down that he was holed up in the town. I left the posse out in the street, and I went in alone to meet Ringo.
Ringo, Ringo.
They said my speed was next to none, but my lightning draw had just begun when I heard a blast that stung my wrist. The gun went flying from my fist, and I was looking down the bore of the deadly 44 of Ringo.
Ringo, Ringo.
They say that was the only time that anyone had seen him smile. He slowly lowered his gun, and then he said to me, "We're even, friend." And so at last I understood that there was still a spark of good in Ringo.
Ringo, Ringo.
I blocked the path of his retreat. He turned and stepped into the street. A dozen guns spit fire and lead. A moment later, he lay dead. The town began to shout and cheer. Nowhere was there shed a tear for Ringo.
Ringo.
The story spread throughout the land that I had beaten Ringo's hand. And it was just the years, they say, that made me put my guns away. But on his grave, they can't explain the tarnished star above the name of Ringo.